And also to mark the 500-day countdown until the Games, IOC President Thomas Bach conducted an exclusive interview with CCTV Sports, in which he expressed the support and confidence of the IOC towards the host city.
虽然您和我之间有6小时的时差，但是我们共同迈进了同样的一天。这一天就是距离北京冬奥会开幕还有500天。在大概5年前，是您把北京成为冬奥会承办城市的消息告诉了世界。过去了这么长时间，时间很快啊。在这个时间点，您最关切北京冬奥会的哪个方面？
First of all, it will be a historic event because Beijing will be the first city which will organize Olympic Games and Olympic Winter Games. This is something very significant in the entire Olympic movement. And we have seen how much the Chinese people are embracing this opportunity by getting familiar with winter sport in record time, by becoming really an emerging nation in winter sports. So this is a significant development which will culminate then in the Olympic Games, for which the preparations there on the technical level are going very, very well. Our Chinese partners in the organizing committee, they have met all the key milestones despite the crisis. So there the stage is set for a successful Olympic Winter Games Beijing 2022 and for writing Olympic history.
谢谢您对北京对中国的信任。前段时间我们也在视频当中见到了您，那是在国际冬季运动北京博览会上面。在开幕式的演讲当中，您曾经提出过，在北京这样一个奥林匹克的城市里举办这样的活动，就是给世界以信心。大家都知道体育正在的危机当中开始复苏了，您能帮我们预测一下未来复苏的前景吗？北京和中国的努力带来怎样的信心？
We all have realized during this crisis that sport is an integral part of human life and how much we are longing for sport and how much we were all longing for having live sports events back. We also have realized how important sport is to bind the community together, that sport is a glue of a society which unites all the people despite all the other difference they may have otherwise. And we have also realized very clearly that sport is a very important economic factor. And in this way, sport can be a positive and can have a positive impact during the crisis, but with its economic strength also contribute to the recovery after the crisis. And there we have a good example in China. There the new winter sport industry has already created 1.5 million jobs in China, and this is even for China, where we in the Western world and in Europe you are used to these big numbers, but I think this 1.5 million jobs is even for China a significant number. For us it's huge.
谢谢您的评价。疫情在中国基本得到控制之后，北京冬奥会的组织筹备工作开始第一时间就重启了。您和您的同志一定一直在观察着北京和中国的努力。对于这样的努力，您如何评价？
The progress is really the Chinese way, if I may say. You see the dynamism and the efficiency of the Chinese people behind these preparations and behind the organization, and you also see the great engagement. When you see that more than 800,000 Chinese people have applied to become a volunteer, when you see the impressive engagement of the Chinese enterprises and businesses supporting the Olympic Games, when you see the Chinese people really starting to play winter sports themselves and to make their kids familiar with winter sports, when you see the infrastructure which has been built and is under construction to accommodate these many, many Chinese people who want to practice winter sport, then you can only be impressed.
谢谢您跟我们一起眺望500天之后的北京冬奥会。 但在迎接北京冬奥会的历史进程当中，一定会首先遇到的是东京奥运会。我也相信很多人在当下会问的一个问题就是，明年的东京奥运会是否会按照推迟之后的时间表如期举行？我们已经吃到了您和您同事给我们的一颗定心丸，说无论疫情如何发展，东京奥运会一定会按照重新改变的日期来举行。那面临这样一个疫情不确定情况下，东京奥运会的办赛会有很多不同的方案在准备着吗？
So we have to prepare for the different scenarios which we may have to face then next July and August in the world, but also in Japan. We cannot be sure today how the world will look like in next year. So we have to prepare for different scenarios. And this is what we are doing together with our Chinese partners. But the same is true with regard to Beijing 2022. There we still do not know whether then in the world we will finally have won the fight against the virus, because the situation, the scenario I'm talking about, does not only depend on the conditions in the host country. It also depends on all the conditions in the other national Olympic committees to see there that the athletes prepare themselves so that they can travel, that they can make sure that they are coming then to a safe environment. So in our preparations, both with regard to Tokyo as with regard to Beijing, there is one principle which governs all our preparations, and this is that the Olympic Games will offer a safe environment for everybody participating.
其实北京冬奥会留给后世的奥林匹克遗产很重要的一点就是3亿人参与冰雪运动。关于这个运动的开展，我们就5年多时间了。对这项运动，我们所做出的努力，您有什么新的感知吗？
I'm really excited about this campaign, and I must say I'm full of admiration for the Chinese people, how they have embraced winter sport in such a short time. So making China now an emerging winter sport nation with this enthusiastic engagement for winter sport and for the Olympic Games. So there I think all the Chinese people can be very, very proud of this, because with this huge engagement of 300 million people becoming familiar with winter sport, I think we can say already now there will be a winter sport in the world before Beijing 2022, and there will be a very different one after Beijing 2022. Winter sport will benefit then from numbers in the engagement of people which these sports have never seen before. And there I can only say thank you to the Chinese people for this enthusiasm and for all your support you're always giving to the Olympic Games.
好，我们希望在冬天来临之前就在北京能遇到您，希望您有机会能在您很欣赏的北京冬奥作为所在的首钢园区，在冰丝带所在的 国家伦匹克中心，也希望您在很多的奥运赛场上，您跟我们一样体会到北京的变化，中国的变化。您像在洛桑一样，继续保持锻炼，继续保持强大。
CZ, thank you all of you, and I'm looking forward to this visit, hopefully very soon.